Theatres across the country are preparing for what will be one of their biggest, most expensive and most popular productions of the year, the Christmas Pantomime. And the Bristol Old Vic Theatre School is no exception. With a cast and crew of over 60 people, consisting of both students and professionals, a challenging set design, an elaborate script, and only 4 weeks until opening night, the bar is high and the pressure is on to deliver one of the most anticipated and ambitious productions of the year. The Bristol Old Vic Theatre School was founded in 1946 by Laurence Olivier, and since then has gone from strength to strength, training students in all aspects of theatre, radio and television drama to become one of the most prestigious drama schools in the country. The theatre school is well known for its classical productions, but for the last 2 years it has produced a Christmas pantomime and is now gearing up to take its third into production. Stevie Hayton is a final year stage management student. She is the deputy stage manager and has been preparing the studio for the day's rehearsals.
Shiver me timbers.
Oh, these not.
Clive Haywood and John Telfer are director and musical director of Dick Whittington, and both wrote the script. The cast consists of final year acting students. They have been given their parts and are getting to grips with their characters and script.
My role is deputy stage manager. I'm kind of the liaison between everyone in the rehearsal room to everyone outside the rehearsal room, the whole technical crew, and anyone that's working with the show. I can take notes within rehearsals with anything that needs to be passed on to any other department, and try and kind of keep the whole process as a whole rather than separate.
I'm playing Dame Sarah the cook, who is the cook at Alderman Fitzwarren's house, and the Dame of the Panto, obviously quite a prominent sort of role that everyone expects when they go to a pantomime. So I felt quite a lot of pressure when I first was given the part, but I've tried to just treat it almost the same as I would any other part. I think there still has to be a sort of truth to the character. And though it's not Chekhov and we're not looking into big histories of the characters or anything like that, there still has to be a bit of semblance of a real person there.
Oh! Hello, dearies!
Hello!
Is anybody out there? I said, hello, dearies!
Yeah, obviously, the level of audience participation does throw up a problem in rehearsals. And Clive and the other people on the production team who've been in rehearsals have been very good at throwing out the responses that we hope we're going to get. When we're not really nervous about it. Clive's pretty confident that he'll have nailed what he thinks the audience, how the audience will respond. Obviously, there might be some days where we get the odd naughty school child who'll throw out little insults, but I think it should be okay. It keeps you on your toes, and I'm quite excited for that sort of part of it.
Although Nick has some previous experience playing comic roles, the challenges of bringing such an iconic and popular character to the stage, whilst still giving her an original twist, could prove to be an interesting journey. The rehearsals are over 4 weeks, starting with blocking the movement, working through the action and the entrances and exits, which will then slot in alongside the various set pieces in the theatre. Down at the Scenic Workshop, set construction is underway. It is an ambitious design and will demand considerable skill by both the construction manager and his team to realise the designer's vision. With just 2 weeks to go before the theatre fit-up, there's still a lot to do, with little time to do it.
His main dress.
Back with the actors, it's Nick's first costume fitting. Vic Aylwin, the costume supervisor, has brought him to Bristol Costume Services to try on a number of outfits. Any chosen ones will then be hired for the show. This not only provides Vic with some of her costumes, but also gives Nick and the other actors a feel for what they will be wearing on the night.
So we're here at Costume Services, and we're just trying on a few of our costumes. I've tried on my fat suit, which I'll be wearing for most of the show. So I've just felt my boobs for the first time.
What I'm doing at the moment is just changing over the handles of the swords. This is King Rat's sword. What they've tried to do with both King Rat and Tommy is kind of give them a colour scheme. King Rat, obviously being dark and evil, has his black and silver. So we're just putting the black on to kind of go with it. The red is more with Tommy because he's a Spanish cat. So they've gone for red and gold to kind of fit in with the colours of the Spanish flag, and also to give him a bit more grandeur because he's a Castilian fighting cat. The fights always keep me a little bit on edge. There are swords, and the swords could go flying into the audience. They could break. The guys could hurt themselves, they can injure themselves, they could fall over at any point.
I mean, we've got three big fight routines, which is, you know, it took up a lot of time in rehearsals. At one point in rehearsals, I was slightly regretting putting in so many fights because it was taking up so many stage hours. But I'm absolutely thrilled with the results. I mean, Johnny Howell has done a fantastic job, and the fighters really know what they're doing. So I think that's sort of a really added element of excitement, particularly for the young ones, to have not one but three stage fights. Once I hit you back, you gave a kick, I gave a slap, you smashed a plate over my head, then I set fire to our bed.